Hi there, I'm Maxen. In today's tutorial, we're going to cover how to easily create, customize, and save certificate templates using PowerPoint. So if you're someone looking for a quick way to create a certificate for your students, or maybe there is an online course you're working on, just follow these steps that we're going to go through in a second, and trust me that by the end of this video, you're going to have all the skills to turn any achievement into a beautiful looking certificate. So without further ado, let's jump into this PowerPoint tutorial. As you can see, we're not starting this tutorial in PowerPoint. The reason for that is that the first thing we need to do is to find ourselves free editable certificate templates in PowerPoint. One of the best places to do that is to go to certifier.io/templates. Now, as you can see, there is a wide range of different templates, all available in different formats, like Figma, PowerPoint, Google Slides, Canva, Word, and even Docs. On the left side, you can see different categories like recognition, training, and course. So you will be 100% equipped with a certificate template that will fit your agenda or needs. Now, since we're here for one purpose, and that is to find certificate templates in PowerPoint, I'm going to go ahead and slide this line right here. And I'm going to look for a tag that says PowerPoint certificate templates. I'm going to click on it. Now, what it did, it filtered out all the certificate templates that were not available in the format of PowerPoint. As you can see, all the certificate templates right here below have a PowerPoint icon, which means that all of them are available in that format. Now, I think I'm going to go ahead and click on this one right here. So you can see, this is a certificate of achievement. It has all the placeholders that we might be interested in, like a placeholder for a logo, title, recipient name and surname, some description, issuing date, name and the surname of the issuing authority, some even lovely badge design, certificate ID, and even a place to put the website of your company. As you can see, this template is available in two different orientations, landscape one and a portrait one. Also, there is another color scheme, which is brown, that you can use as well. Now, to download the certificate template that you want, first select it in the sidebar here below. I'm gonna go ahead with this blue one. So to download the certificate template that we've just chosen, just go ahead and click on this PowerPoint icon right here. What this will do is start a download of a zip file to your computer. I'm gonna go ahead and click on save right here. Now, as you can see here, we have the zip file. First thing to do is to actually unzip it. Just double click on it and it will turn from a zip file to a regular folder. Let's open it up. As you can see, there are four elements: fonts folder, readme, and two certificate templates available in two orientations. One in the landscape one, the other one is a portrait one. Now, before you go ahead and start opening these certificate templates, make sure that you install all the fonts. So if you want your certificate template to look exactly like this, you need to first install all the fonts. There's actually a very easy way to do that. Just open the fonts folder, go to the specific font that you want to install, and just double click on it. What this will do is actually offer you an option to add this font to your font book. Just click on install the font. This font will automatically be added to your font book. As you can see, here's my font that I've just successfully uploaded to my computer. Now I'm going to go ahead and repeat the same procedure for all the fonts. Now, after you install all the fonts, you might as well just click on the certificate template that you want to customize and open it in PowerPoint. Now, if you've done everything correctly, this is exactly how your certificate should be looking like in PowerPoint. As you can see, this certificate is the exact copy of this preview on the Certifier website. Now, first things first, let's check what is the size of this certificate. Let's go to the file, page setup. As you can see, it has the width of 29.7 centimeters and the height is 21 centimeters. This is a predefined A4 format. By the way, all the certificate templates that you can find on Certifier come in predefined A4 format. So when it comes to a landscape format or portrait one, both of them are in A4. So now let's start customizing our certificate. I'm gonna go ahead and start with changing the title of our certificate template. Let's change it from certificate of achievement to certificate of recognition. There we go. Now I'm gonna go ahead and change the name of the recipient from James McAllister to Andrew Brown. Now, I'm not quite happy with the font size of the recipient name. To be precise, I want to increase it. So the way to do that is to select the entire text box. Just click on the border of this text box and go to the font size tab on top and choose the font size that you want. I'm going to go ahead with 80. Now, I'm more pleased with how it looks like, so I'm going to leave it at that. When it comes to description, I think it's too big and I'm thinking of just getting rid of the second sentence right here. I'm gonna select all of it and just press delete on my keyboard. Now, you might have noticed that the text is not aligned perfectly. And I'm gonna go ahead and transfer the title of this course to the second line by pressing enter on my computer. Now let's go ahead and change the issuing date from 22nd of January to the 1st of February, 2023. Now, there are two names for the issuing authority, two people who will be signing your certificate once it's issued. I'm gonna go ahead and change the name from Andrew to Marcus. Now, as you can see, there are three or more elements that we can work on, which is a badge, certificate ID, and the website of our company. I'm gonna go ahead and change the certificate ID to 001 as last three digits. Now I'm gonna go ahead and select the entire website text holder and get rid of it by clicking delete on my keyboard. And the last thing to do is to change the text inside your badge. From your text, let's change it to nice job. There we go. Now, one of the last things you can do with the certificate is to personalize it with your own logo. To do that, just substitute the placeholders that we have right here on top with your own logo. First things first, I'm gonna go ahead and select each of these elements and just get rid of them by clicking delete on my button. Now I'm gonna go ahead to insert, pictures, picture from file. I have already prepared a generic university logo that I'm gonna use. Please make sure that your logo is in a PNG format, which means that it doesn't have any background. Just double click on it and it will appear on your certificate template. Now I'm gonna use these tools to resize my certificate logo and place it in the middle of my certificate. Now, you know that you can manually drag this logo to the middle of the certificate and try to perfectly align it with respect to other elements. But you don't actually have to do that because PowerPoint offers a tool that will do that for you. Just select the element that you want to align and go ahead to the upper tab, click on Align, and click on Align to Center. What this will do is align your element perfectly with respect to all other elements in the middle of the certificate. Now, I think I'm quite happy with the final result. Now I'm gonna go ahead and try to print my certificate. To do that, just go ahead to the file and click on print. What this will do is open a pop-up window where you can select your printer, number of copies, and as you can see, printer already identified that we have an A4 format, which is beautiful, and you don't have to make any other adjustments. Now, another thing that you can do is to try and save your certificate. PowerPoint offers a beautiful option of saving your certificates in PDF. To do that, just go ahead to the file, save as, and let's name our certificate, Certificate of Recognition. Now in the field file format, from the drop-down menu, select PDF. Then click on save. Now let's go ahead and check out if our certificate was saved correctly. Now, as you can see, I've just opened my certificate and everything was saved perfectly. We have our new logo, name, new title of the certificate, new recipient name, a smaller description, new issuing date, new names of the issuing authorities that will be signing my certificate, updated text in a badge, and an updated certificate ID. So there you go. You just learned that PowerPoint can be a good tool to customize certificate templates, but it has its limitations when it comes to issuing certificates in bulk. And that's where Certifier comes in. So remember that if you're looking for a one-stop shop for all things certificates related, you definitely need to check out certifier.io or just click on the first link in the description down below. If you're someone who appreciates a written guide, we got you covered as well. We have this exact tutorial available in a step-by-step format on our blog. So if you want to check it out, I'll leave the link in the description down below. If you want to learn how to create certificate templates in other apps like Microsoft Word or Google Slides, we have tutorials like these as well. I'll leave all the links in the description down below, so feel free to check them out as well. Thanks for watching, and I see you in the next one.